In our previous video, Dr. Riz walked you through planting your first seeds for your hydroponics indoor garden. You will need rock wool, grow trays, and non-GMO seeds. This easy step-by-step video will take you from day one of planting the seeds through day seven, when your seedlings are now ready to sit under the LED lights. We will link that video in the description box below. In this video, Dr. Riz shows you how to prepare your reservoir containers for your seedlings' new home. Let's get started.
So I have 2 meters. I have a pH meter.
I have a TDS meter.
So the TDS meter, it measures parts per million. And you just dip it into the water about there. And then right here on the thing, it'll tell you the parts per million. And that helps you get your nutrient level. The nutrient that I use, Maxi Grow by General Hydroponics. And it's a 10-5-14 mix. And so it's apparently a very good, just general hydroponics nutrient solution.
Before preparing the new reservoirs, Dr. Riz decided to clear some of the first plants that he initially grew. Some of the plants had bolted and were at the end of their life. We will make a separate video explaining what that means. You will see that he kept the basil plant and will add new seedlings in that container. Although today we would not recommend mixing mature plants with seedlings because both need different nutrient levels and the basil was quickly drinking up the water. In total, you will see 3 containers being prepped in this video.
And so this one I'm going to start completely brand new. These are the pots for the rock wool. This is what the air stone looks like. They come in different sizes, but this one's a long flat one. There's also, they come as brown balls. So I'm going to fill this one up with water, and then I'm going to add a nutrient solution to it per the instructions on the Maxi Grow bag. I'll be back in a second. All right, I'm back, and I have filled this container, I think, with about a gallon and a half of water. Okay, so I've added my water, and they say to put the get the water level to the point where when you put the cup, the water is just below the bottom of the cup, and I think I got that just about right. If I look at it at different places, the water is just maybe a millimeter or so below the bottom of the cup. So the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and add nutrient to the solution. This is about a gallon and a half, and per the directions here, it's 1 to 2 teaspoons per gallon. And so I'm going to go ahead and put in, I don't want to put in 2 teaspoons per gallon because that's going to get me to my full nutrient level. I'm trying to achieve a nutrient level of about 1500 TDS instead of 3000 TDS. And because you want to be a little bit light on the nutrient for seedlings and then increase the nutrient level as they grow. So if I have 1.5 gallons, let's say I want to use 1 teaspoon per gallon, so I'm going to use 1.5 teaspoons to start and then check my TDS. I can always add a little bit more, but once you've added too much, then it's a little bit harder to get your nutrient level down other than diluting the water and then pulling some off. So there's one. And a half. And then I'm going to connect the aerator line. It's bubbling, and that's going to help mix it up, although I will physically also mix up the water some as well. And then I'll come back in a few minutes and check the nutrient level and the pH level. So while we're waiting for that, I'm going to go back and check the pH on this here, since I tried to adjust it with a little bit of lime juice. I'm going to go ahead and take a pH without the aerator on and see if that gives me a steady reading. This one's getting close to being ready. This one we've just put the nutrients in. I'm going to give it a little while longer to circulate and mix, and then we'll come back and check our pH and nutrients. Okay, so we've made some adjustments to the nutrient solutions, and I'm going to come back and check them. I'm just going to turn the aerator off. This is the one that I put some lime juice in order to bring the pH down, and might as well just check the TDS. 1595, same as it was before. And then the pH, which I'd like to be between 6 and 7, and I've been trying to get it on the lower side of 6. We're around 6.2, so I'm happy with that. So that's where we're going to start with. And then on this one, I added a little bit more nutrient solution, and we got it up to 1497, and I wanted it around 1500, so I'm happy with that. And then, as I said earlier, the nutrient solution naturally brings the pH down, and the pH is right at 6.0, 6.01, 6.03, so I'm happy with that. The pH tends to go up as over time, so I'm happy to start on the lower end of the scale that the plants need, and then adjust it as needed, because you also have to add nutrient over time. As the pH goes up and you need to add more nutrient, it will bring the pH back down. That's at least what I found in my experience in the first 4 months of using my hydroponic garden. So the next step will be to get our seedlings, actually plant them in our hydroponic garden. So I was setting up this separate tub here for the peppers, because the peppers require a different TDS and a different pH than the lettuce. I want the TDS to be between 2100 and 2400. That's about spot on. That's at 2400 right there. And we want the pH to be between 5.8 and 6.5. And the pH, unfortunately, is 4.5. So I already showed you earlier how to bring the pH down when I put lime over here. So now I'm going to use baking soda to bring the pH up. And I'll use a little bit at a time because I really don't know how much is necessary. So just as a gauge, right now my pH is 4.4, and I'm gonna put 1 teaspoon in and then see what difference that makes so that I can help gauge how much more to put in later. Actually, I think I'm gonna put in 1/2 teaspoon because I really have no idea how much this is gonna raise it. So I'm glad I put just 1/2 teaspoon because that brought it right up to a pH of 6, which is perfect. And so now we are ready to put our peppers in here. So the first one here is a serrano pepper. I could either put this here like that, or I am going to go ahead and put it on the bottom like that. This is the cubanelle. See these two empty areas, which I'm trying to give their space because these are going to grow into smaller bushes or plants, and I don't want them to be crowded. We don't want the roots to be exposed to the light, so I'm going to cover those with cardboard cutouts, which I have previously made, just like that. We're done planting our peppers. They're kind of on autopilot now. When the plants are small and they're growing, they don't take up much water, so this water that we have here is going to last quite a while until we get some bigger plants. And then as the plants grow bigger, we tend to have to put more water in over time. And as you put more water, again, you want to balance both the nutrient level and the pH. And then I might add that I have one grow light right here dedicated to the pepper plants. I'm going to put this on a 17 hours on, 7 hours off cycle. So every night it shuts off at midnight with a timer, and then turns on at 7 a.m. So not only are we giving them full strength daylight for 17 hours, but we're also aerating the water, so that's gonna force these plants to grow faster. Probably at a rate anywhere from 2 to 5 times faster than normal. So that's it for the peppers, and now on to some lettuce. As you saw, I've got my Paris Island romaine rock wool put into the cups. I've put some clay pebbles around them to support them and to hide the light. And now all I need to do is drop them in my water. Let's see. And that's it. So now we will just kind of check on them daily and hope and pray that they grow nicely. Take care.
Alright, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe, because next time Dr. Riss will talk to you about pairing your seeds. When he first planted his seeds, he added 3 seeds per rock wool. This allows him to choose the best seedling to transplant into the reservoir container. This is called pairing your seeds. Okay, thanks for watching.
Don't forget to subscribe. subscribe.
Hit that notification button.